I was broken from a young age, taking my soak into the masses, writing my poems for the few that look at me, took to me, shook at me, feeling me, singing from heartache, from the pain, taking my message from the veins, speaking my lesson from the brain, seeing the beauty through the bomb has been planted.
Hey, you made me up, you made me up, believer.
Shot onto Apex. Is he going to try and go huge here? Kenny S on site, straight in his face. Doesn't hit the nose go. Doesn't hit the pistol. Oh, for the knife! Kenny S, would you believe it? The balls on that man to go.
And Kenny, there to trade things back. It is a one on two. The one that's been called into question a little bit on the side of G2, going to find himself with the AWP in hand, locked in this 1v2, and be baiting out the defuse. It does mean that Crimson and Dennis both going for the peak. Bomb's going to be planted in a bit of an obscure location, but they do know where it is. He's just going to stick it, going to be tagged down fairly low, but waiting, going to rush through the smoke. Crims goes down. Kenny 1v1, not much time left, and he's sticking it. In comes Dennis, God. And he's going to fall as well.
The fast pushes from Titan have been called and found out, but there's Kenny S with two, and a third as well, and a fourth! Unbelievable play from Kenny,
It's Kerrigan, then gets a bomb down thereafter. This is going to be very difficult. He doesn't have like any time to work with. The bomb plant's going to take 5 seconds alone. He's going to go for it behind the fountain. Kerrigan just going to charge him down. He's going to miss quite a few pistol shots. Kenny S, he picks up the kill! Kerrigan should not have put that! He gets the second! Kenny S clutches the round! Oh my lord, that should not happen!
Happy bombsite once again. You would expect them to be doing something pretty fast here with the smoke grenade, perhaps. Oh. And that shot from Dupree takes down Zendo. Fantastic use of the new hitboxes there.
And sprays through the wall. Dupree's on fire!
There's no chance for TSM to really do much of anything. Dupree will come around, pick up a good kill there, but they know where he is, gets another headshot, and a third one as well, takes down Guardian now, he's just got one click left here for Seize, wrapping around, does do a lot of damage, Seize is on 8 health, one more bullet's gonna do it, he's running up here, got 40 seconds, but Seize is already out of there, gonna put up a smoke.
And now it's a very difficult situation here for Dupree, because as soon as he taps that bomb, Seize is gonna be on him, and now Seize is one step ahead, it's gonna come down to this push here, Dupree working the angle, but Seize ready and waiting, and he jumps!
Seize jumps! What was that?
Wow.
He doesn't have the time for the defense.
Great. It's all around him towards the garage as well. Make waves on the air conditioning unit, and it's up to Dupree now. I've got a feeling he's going to find a couple of frags, and this is looking quite promising considering he had backup. Ready to take. Oh, I wouldn't say one down, but here's Dupree, like I said, a couple of kills, looking very good. And he spots a third as well. There it is, Matt. It was all looking so nice for him, and he delivers.
Not bad at all. Next to the gun.
He's been found out. Forest dropping very low on health. Got to be a bit careful. Scout from Fallen, not really been put into play yet.
Oh, and the shots. I mean, Taco, he's up close. He's got that USB. Let's see if he can find a shot here. Close. Nicely done. That's the bomb carrier as well. Pinned down, so that wasn't going to help. But Alu, still wreaking havoc in the back lines. Picks off Fair. And Taco, mid-air, double kill, and he's gonna set up for the triple as well. Alu sitting on four. If he pulls off this clutch, it's the ace, but it's not meant to be.
Jump peeking it, gonna spot it out. Taco finds him. That's, I guess, a step in the right direction, but there's gonna be a lot more steps here on what might be a mountain, but there's a leap. Taco just completely eviscerates Kyo, and now it's for 1v2. A little more possible, but look at the time, 25 seconds. A smoke and a flash is all he has, but he needs one more kill here.
He's gonna go events, isn't he? That's gonna be the scary thing he says to go for it. So no, he's actually gonna come out towards.
Is he?
Oh no, he's not. He's baiting it out. This so smart.
Sick.
He's got four kills. He has to go for the ace here. He's got to get all five.
This man is certainly aware of what could be coming his way. So every single position he checks, every angle contains a threat. But would you predict Taco to take a fight here? Confidence aplenty. And we'll see if it pays off. And he gets it. That's a sick ace from Taco. That is not what you see every day.
SK Gaming, though, they have two men still in position, and look at that headshot from Taco taking down Device. That is a fantastic way to get started, especially dropping Device, and now they're starting to rotate in. SK have a really good read on the situation right now. They know this is going to be a beat hit, and all of that distraction from Astralis hasn't really helped them at all. Taco landing one more headshot, taking down Dupree, looking for a third. He's calmly clicking away. There's a third coming in. Taco doing more, fourth headshot, and the round has been won.
pas attention à ça. Juste, soyez directement dans la game, go crier, go s'enflammer, ok, comme hier, la même rage. Et les gars, s'il y a un pote qui se tape, tout de suite on va l'aider, ok, faut que ça soit énergétique. Il y a un mouvement sur une zone, tout de suite on fait un truc, on va aider un pote, ça flash, ça smoke, ça si, ça, ok, ça bouge, il y a de la vie, on joue à CS, on joue ensemble, on joue en teamplay. S'il y a un pote qui se tape, on va l'aider et nique sa mère. Si le mec en face il fait 3 kills, il fait une action vidéo, il fait une action vidéo, on s'en bat les couilles. Mais c'est comme à la guerre, ok, on est entre nous, on est dans la même merde, on est les 5 doigts d'une main et il faut qu'on le ressente in game, ok les gars.
To shoot people in the face, and he will close the distance if he has to. Look at that, one bullet fired, one man down. He may get taken down from the back though. What is shot? Are you serious? You can't do this. No.
He's been top fragging for a very long time here on Dust2. It's on Shox in a 1-on-3 to try and keep it alive, otherwise we'll go to a fifth map in the Grand Finals. Shox tabs out one, and that's a deadly kill. Goes for the second, and he's moving closer, looking for the quad clutch here. FNX, the last man alive, he's gonna tap the bomb once. Shox breaks. Shox! You've got to be kidding, he takes the quad kill! And that.
Agora o Fury tá chegando nas costas, mas olha só, hein? Vai dando a volta com os Zipex, preparar esse smoke. É a C4, o Fury pode segurar ela. Vai contra as Zipex ali pulando, deixou passar, procura o HS e consegue levar um. O segundo, C4 dropada. Device não vai vir pelas costas do Fury, que tá marcando agora o sapão. Vem marcando aqui pela bifurca. Já chega a equipe da CK fazendo um pezinho lá por trás. Não vão deixar que os jogadores entrem com o sapão. E marca aqui ainda, enquanto o Device vai voltando agora pra CK. 50 segundos faltando. Seria interessante se o Fê conseguisse voltar pro bom site B, mas ele vai ficar marcando aqui a passagem. Vai contar a primeira agora, atingiu a cabeça, olha o Fê em busca do quarto, vai em busca do quarto kill. Device vindo por cima, ele escutou, encontrou, não sinalizou, agora sim, olha o Ace, meu Deus, que homem!
Smoke makes a problematic situation. Varex could slip in. They backed off. He's perfect. If he goes, it's a sitting duck and he's gonna line them up. Oh, he's blind though. He's gotta line this up. He's gotta get it perfect. One goes down. Sprays for the second spot at the third as well. He's got it. Well done, Fur. Gifted the
end. Fallen and Fur have to fight back in Fur through connector. Lines up both of them. Will clean them up as he is in a 1v3. Has to ace to pick this round up for SK. As C9 have kind of done a good job at shutting down the plat and drop room pressure simultaneously.
And we watched NBK win a 1v5, so anything is possible. Fur creeps through the smoke, could have taken out Shroud and left this to the 1v1. Oh, he's dropped it, so it's just down to Shroud, who needs another kill, but Fur with a 1v3 ace. Fantastic round from him.
Brazilian Counter-Strike has been led by the play of SK Gaming, but it has not solely been a one-team story. Yet, Immortals always stumbled when it came time to qualify for the major, finally securing that coveted spot. They are driven by the desire to embark upon their own quest for gold, tempered by the consistent style of Bolts, who has played in the playoffs of majors already. New talent KNG brings the kind of off-ping Brazil is famous for.